Now, for the toffee apples, you need brown sugar, ideally. And I've got 8 ounces of brown sugar. And I'm putting that into the pan. There we are. Got a little bit dry. There we are. Whoops. And 1 ounce of butter. And then golden syrup, a tablespoon. This is an old-fashioned tablespoon. And I'm making quite sure that it's only a level one. Nothing underneath. There, it's just about level. Into the pan, and then a teaspoonful of vinegar, and it wants to be just white vinegar, that's the clear vinegar, and then 4 tablespoonfuls of water. But first of all, just got to scrape the tablespoon clean. There we are. And it doesn't really matter if you have a shade more water, because in fact you boil away most of the liquid anyway. 2, 3, 4. There we are. So all the ingredients are in the pan to start with. Put it on the cooker. And it's very important, as if you're making caramel custard or any caramel, to cook it very, very slowly to start with, because you've got to wait until there's no crunch. You hear now it's quite scratchy on the bottom. And you have to dissolve it very, very slowly. So dissolve that slowly, and I'm going to leave that just on 2, looking after itself. Meanwhile, I've got some caramel that's been boiling for about between 5 and 10 minutes. It's just been very, very gently here while I was talking. And it's now at the exact temperature it should be, which, to be technical, is 290 degrees Fahrenheit, which is 43 degrees centigrade. Now, very few people have got thermometers. So if you haven't got a thermometer, first of all, take it out. If you're using one, put it in hot water, and then it will not break the thermometer. If you put it in cold water or leave it lying about, it might crack. So to tell if you haven't a thermometer, it's boiled enough, take a little on a spoon and drop it into cold water. And if it goes to the bottom and is absolutely solid, as this is, it's called the crack stage. Now that is absolutely solid, and that will cling on to the apples, let's hope. So there we are, the quick test. It looks a darker colour. I'm going to put the spoon over there and dip the apples into the mixture. To take the apples, take an apple, these are English coxes, and they're nice firm, and I particularly use small apples, because if I find that with my own children, if you use a big apple, they don't get all the way through it. Dip it, put the stick in, and Mrs. Kellett, Granny, very kindly bought me these sticks from her butchers, because they're in fact skewers. I use a little piece of doweling, which you can get from a hardware shop, or you can buy lolly sticks if you like. So you can use doweling, lolly sticks, or skewers. Make sure the apple has been well washed and you've taken the stalk out, then take the apple and dip it into the mixture and run it round. And in fact, I want to take that just off so it doesn't cook anymore because it's reached the temperature. And then run it round, and then immediately dip it into water, cold water, and that. Did you notice how quickly I did it? You must do it very quickly, because otherwise it does run off. And this has stopped it running off, and as you can see, it is ready to just set now. There we are, that's setting, it's shiny, and the butter makes it that much nicer to taste. And I've put it onto wax paper. I saved this paper out of the cornflake packet, so that's free. So just stand it on that, and then you wait for it to absolutely set. And this amount of mixture makes 6 apples, and then you get a little bit left like that, and you can see, I'll bang it, it's absolutely firm. So there we are, those are these apples, but there is a quick recipe that I want to show you, which I think Lorna would enjoy more herself to make. So in this bowl I've got 8 ounces of sieved icing sugar, and I've mixed 2 tablespoonfuls of drinking chocolate, that's the sweetened one, and then you take an apple that's been washed and got a stick in, and you just dip it into this. So that's icing sugar, 8 ounces, and 2 tablespoonfuls of chocolate powder, and you mix it with about 2 tablespoonfuls of water, maybe a little bit more, and then you just quickly do that. And then coat them with Rice Krispies. And if you notice that this amount of mixture makes 6, I'm very short, because my children, in fact, yesterday I had them all out when I was practicing, and they've eaten 2 of them already. But they are nice and firm. Let me just remind you how to make the chocolate apples, because I find that for my own children, they make them themselves, and they're very easy and quite safe to make. You need 6 small eating apples. I usually use the small coxes. Then 8 ounces of icing sugar, which must be sieved, otherwise it could make a lumpy mixture. 2 tablespoonfuls of drinking chocolate. You mix the icing sugar and the drinking chocolate together with about 2 to 3 tablespoonfuls of hot water, very hot water, and you make it the consistency that you would ice a chocolate cake. And then you dip the chocolate, the apples into the chocolate and then into Rice Krispies and leave them to set for about 3 hours. And I think they're rather good.